There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations they put up in the gardens? So beautiful. You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us.
We've certainly come a long way, haven't we?
I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. It means a lot to be able to share that with someone. Someone I can trust.
If handmaidens don't help each other in King's Landing, nobody will.
Thank you, Mira. And you know I'll always help you too. Hold on, look. There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be a handmaiden forever. And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have. I have to go talk to him. Marjorie won't notice it for a few minutes longer. Could you make an excuse for me? Please.
Go on then. It'll be fine. The wedding's still days away.
Thank you, Mira. I knew I could count on you.
What are you doing here?
I know I shouldn't be here, but we have to talk. I didn't know when I would see you next.
Look, that night, I don't know what might have happened if you hadn't helped me.
I could say the same to you, Lady Mira. But I came here to warn you. I was down in Fleabottom last night when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing. Probably dead. They're questioning people. Searching for his body.
They don't have any proof he's dead, do they?
They found blood on the garden stones by the fountain. But they can't know it's his. No one will know what you did. What? What is it? If we're gonna survive this...
What if they find his knife? I threw it away, and there was blood on it.
Oh, no. You do not want to get caught looking for it. Just don't get in any more trouble, and I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
You saved my life. I don't even know your name.
It's Tom.
Thank you. Tom.
Don't thank me yet, Lady Mira. There's still a knife out there covered with a dead man's blood. And I don't...
Mira!
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy? Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing...
Oh, thank the gods you came along, Sarah. That boy. He fancies me. He'll find any excuse to talk. I just don't have the heart to drive him off.
So you misled him? I wouldn't waste the time. Come on. Marjorie expects us at the throne room. We don't want to be late.
You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way.
Well, first of all, his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent. He told me the cleverest story about this festival they have where they celebrate.
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the Reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace, my lady.
Which reminds me... Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your Grace,
speak out of turn, girl...
I...
You should finish what you start.
Your Grace, we must do as Our Lady commands us. If Marjorie has need of us during the wedding,
then... The King's safety is more important than straightening your lady's gown. I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the King. Clearly, she still hasn't learned respect for the crown. You won't like that so much when you're the one wearing it. In any case, it's settled. The King's Guard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Marjorie, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
What did she mean by that? You and Tyrion? What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
Tyrion... he offered to help my family.
He did? Then surely he expects something in return. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister behind my back. I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
My family needs me. We're losing everything. I have to do whatever I can to help them.
I'm not blind to your pain, Mira, but your problems are not the only ones in the world. Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be. Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm sorry, my lady, I made a mistake. It won't happen again. Please don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
Roderick, it's the White Hills. They're assembling in the courtyard. They've woken the house. You can't let this go on. They want to see us cower.
What in damnation are they doing?
They just showed up here, started banging their shields.
I'll need my sentinel. Go ahead, Talia, and have Roiland meet me in the courtyard.
What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way.
This ends now. Get out of my sight.
Those are strong words. For a cripple who can't carry a sword.
All of you, show your respect to Griff Whitehill, fourth-born son of Lord Lud Whitehill and commander of this garrison.
Cocky Roderick, we used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you, eh?
Roderick the Ruined.
I hardly recognize you. But the name fits, don't it? Pathetic.
Make no mistake, Griff. I'm still the Lord of Ironwrath, and I run this house.
That sounds like the old Roderick, beating his chest every chance he got.
I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one is happy. So my men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me.
I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth. Maybe that's how foresters live, but not us.
I'll take care of my house. You take care of your men. And let us keep them apart.
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line. You think you're being clever?
If your men don't like it here, you can march them back to High Point.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the King's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right. We're here under the orders of Roos Bolton, Warden of the North. So I will be in your halls. I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this, little bastard. You can't just do whatever...
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You don't want to go to battle within these walls. We need to make this work.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now, me and my men will take our place in your hall. Unless you think you and your army can stop me. No, you know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick!
You can't go in there.
We can and we will.
Unless you want this all to end right now, eh?
I'm the only lord here. Come on.
Griff Whitehill, that snot-nosed fourthborn, parading in here like a conquering fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, my lord. But we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break, and the way Griff Whitehill came in, that's clearly what he wants.
We can't go to war within our own walls. Whatever we do, we have to be careful.
But Griff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms, and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point.
How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head.
Griff is in the head. It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan. He carved these soldiers himself. Ramsay Snow killed Ethan. What's to stop the Whitehills from doing the same to Ryan at High Point? You can't forsake his safety.
But we have to do something.
My lord, at least give us a target to aim for.
Get Ryan out and bring him home. Once he's safe, we can
can face the White Hills head on.
And what of Griff and his men?
But we can only take this occupation for so long.
Speak true. Would you just let Ryan die?
No, my lord.
Roderick is right. We are nothing if we leave Ryan behind.
Then it's decided. We're bringing Ryan back.
We still don't have the men to hold our own home, let alone storm High Point. We lost most of our men with Gregor at the Twins.
Thankfully, Roderick secured an alliance with the Glenmores.
But those forces mean nothing until after the marriage.
That means we have to count on Asha and Myrrha.
How?
Asha means to sail home from Essos with a company of hardened sellswords.
But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it.
Which is why Myrrha's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have the luxury of waiting for them. Asha and Myrrha are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Lud Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
If we have to go to battle before we're ready, we risk losing everything. But sometimes you have no choice.
That time may indeed come, but it's not now. The White Hills aren't ready for war.
It won't be long before you're able to take action yourself.
Well, one way or another, there's a fight brewing, so I have much to prepare, and men to train.
My lord?
My lord, there may be something we can do now.
A voice from High Point.
Gwyn Whitehill.
Lord Whitehill's daughter?
The very same.
After the hells that came from her and Asha.
Despite all that, she's willing to meet with you. I may not be your sentinel, but please consider this. It would be wise to hear what she has to say.
Do you think she can be trusted?
It's possible she has other motives, but it's a chance to learn more about our enemies. We need to take it, and I'll make sure no one else knows. For now, at least.
Good.
Handle things right with Gwyn, and she may even help us in High Point, when the time comes.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. And these flowers, they're just all wrong in the Crownlands. Myrrha, are you listening to me?
Lady Marjorie, good tidings to you today.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Myrrha, a word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be the Queen. And if you're anything like the current one, you'll deny me all you like.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion, but Lady Marjorie needs me.
Very well. Just know that matter we discussed? A royal decree sits on my desk now. I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. I thought you would want to know. Good news on a day that is already blessed.
My lord, I know there will be talk. But my family needs this.
It's in good hands, Lady Myrrha. Oh, one more thing. The most valuable favor is a favor unspent. Perhaps I'll call on you for a dance at the wedding feast. Enjoy the festivities.
Goodbye, Lord Tyrion.
Lady Marjorie, welcome to the family. For better or worse.
Lord Tyrion. Just how is he helping your family? What's this talk of a royal decree? You know I didn't want you talking to him.
I made a deal with him. For the crown to buy my family's ironwood.
Think of how this will look. House Forrester already has so few friends at court. And when this decree becomes public, you may find you have even fewer.
You disappoint me, Myrrha.
We'll talk about this after the wedding. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair.
But...
come with me, Sarah.
Garrett!
Easy now.
Sorry. I was just keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want? Not many people pass through here. What brought him this far?
He was just delivering ironwood shields for the Night's Watch.
Good. Our stocks are running low. I know it couldn't be easy seeing him, but you have to leave all that behind. Especially now that you're a ranger.
Aye.
I know you had told me you could stand with these men, but not every brother's a friend, if it came to it. And you were in trouble north of the wall. Any of them you'd trust by your side?
You know these men. Who do you want watching your back?
Well, I know I can count on you, John.
I'm flattered. But our paths may not always cross. You'll need allies beside you.
Erolt Holt of White Harbor, Corliss Wells from Stony Sept. And finally, we've got more spawn of nobility joining us.
No.
Brit Warwick of House Whitehill.
It can't be.
House Whitehill. Make sure you're not bringing this one for the Boltons.
There'll be a hot meal in the mess hall. After that, we'll be sorting out gear at the armory.
Garrett.
There'll be practice swords to
Garrett,
start.
What's the master?
Don't want anyone.
You know him.
Come on, get moving.
Garrett, who is he?
That man murdered my family.
What?
Snow! See these new recruits to the maester.
Don't do something you regret.
If it isn't the fucking pig farmer. I'm here because of you. Got sent to the wall for that little party I do with your family. Don't think it's over. Best watch your back.
What are you waiting for, recruit?
I got nothing to say to you. Now get out my sight.
And will you make me?
That's enough, both of you. I said move.
I'll be seeing you, farm boy.
This isn't fair. We were supposed to be up there. I'll never see another wedding like this. I don't know what you did with Tyrion Lannister that made Cersei want to punish you, but it never should have affected me like this. You just don't get it, Sarah. I've been fighting for my family's lives here, and what Tyrion Lannister did for me, it may have saved them. Whether you have a seat at the wedding just isn't as important.
I see. Well, I hope it was worth it, because you don't know how furious Margaery is at you. When I was getting her dressed for the wedding, she was talking about who she could replace you with. I probably shouldn't have even told you, but I suppose you have a right to know.
I can handle this. She's only thinking about it, right? There's still time.
It's funny how things change, isn't it? I seem to remember, not too long ago, I was asking for your help with Margaery. And now here we are, with you on the outside needing my help. So, go on, ask me for it.
Unless you want Margaery to make you leave King's Landing.
Sarah, I was wrong not to offer you my help. I can only ask you to be a better friend than I was to you. Don't worry. We'll figure this out. I'll beg Margaery if I have to. I'm not letting her send you home.
Look, the pie!
Oh no! They're already serving the pie.
Oi!
We're missing everything.
I know you. You were in the gardens the other night with Damien. Before he disappeared. I have a few questions to ask you. What were you doing there with him?
Mira?
Don't think I don't know it was you.
So what if I was with him?
Seven hells.
You there, girl. I need a towel or a wet cloth, something.
Lord Morgren.
You'll need to find someone else. I'm not finished
with her. Are you sick, man? You think I have time to bother with handmaidens? Release her, or I'll have Queen Cersei find you another job. Well, I just ruined a perfectly good shirt to come to your rescue. No need to explain what that was all about.
That was kind of you. I do appreciate it.
Well, I didn't do it merely for your benefit.
Then why?
Perhaps I recognize a kindred spirit. It's not every little handmaiden who can steal an ironwood decree with the crown right out from under my nose. Consider me impressed. My partners, I am afraid to say, felt rather differently about it.
That ironwood was stolen from my family. It was never yours to sell.
Spoken with strength, my lady. But still, I wonder if you're ready to play this game. Do you even understand why Tyrion gave you the ironwood deal? Because it wasn't out of the kindness of his heart.
I'm no fool. He wants something from me. Access to Margaery. Or perhaps he just knew he could get the cheapest ironwood from me.
Very observant. You are no mere handmaiden. I remember what it was like to be new to this game. You feel like you're drowning, don't you? But there's no one you can really trust. What you need more than anything is an ally. I could be that for you, Lady Mira. Is that something you'd be interested in?
And what exactly are the terms of this offer? What do you get out of it?
A smart question. So, let me be blunt. Circumstances have put us at odds. But what if we were to work together? Control the price of ironwood together? We could get very, very rich together. Or should I go back to Lord Whitehill? Who has proven to be very interested in it.
What happened? Joffrey's dead!
I'm afraid it just became a very bad time to be linked to Tyrion Lannister. Tell me that you got that ironwood decree from him before the wedding.
Oh no. He said it was waiting for me on his desk.
What a shame. Such potential. I'm afraid any chance of our alliance has become quite impossible. You understand, Lady Mira.
I can get it. I'll get it back from his chambers.
That would not be an easy task, especially now. But if it were to disappear, perhaps we could talk again. You have a good head for business, Lady Mira. It'd be terribly disappointing to see it on the end of a pike.
Not getting in this way.
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave. Now.
Tom, I'm in trouble. There's something inside I need to get. If I don't, it's going to be a nightmare.
Damn it. Whatever trouble you're in could be trouble for me too.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly around here.
Tom, I really need your help here. I can't do this alone. Just be careful.
Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place. Don't you know the imp has murdered the king?
I work for Lady Marjorie. Queen Marjorie. She asked me to wait here.
Somehow I find that hard to believe. I'm not going to ask you again. Oi! Whoever's in there, I command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You! Don't move!
Tom! It's me! Hurry!
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose.
Thank you, Tom. I could never have done this without you. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree!
Well, go on! That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
He said that it would be on his desk! It's the bill for the wedding. This is more money than I could spend in a lifetime. Tyrion Strongbox. Oh, it must be in here.
Mira, I think the Lannister guard is back.
No, no, it's the other one.
Damn it, hide! I find a way to distract them.
I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them.
And after? Now that we've got the imp's keys, we can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
Help! Fire!
What the hell? Damn it! Come on!
You did it! How?
I lit a tapestry on fire, down the hall. I'll watch you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. Oh, it has to be. No.
Just hurry!
Oh!
Come on!
It worked! Is this? Oh, thank the gods! Oh, I found it!
Finally! Let's go!
If I catch the bastard who... I'll wring their bloody neck!